Hi guys, Story Recaps here. Today, I am going to explain a 2020 American science fiction, action, horror film, called, Underwater. Spoilers ahead. Watch out, and take care. The film opens at Kepler 822, a Tian Industries facility used for ocean research and drilling. Nora Price, a mechanical engineer, is going about her morning routine when the lights begin to flicker and a leak appears on the ceiling. She exits the toilet to investigate when she is hit by the abrupt waves coming through the walls, indicating a pressure break. She dashes down a hallway, attempting to warn everyone passing by to rush to the bulkhead, but only Rodrigo Nagenda follows her. They want to seal the doors once they reach the bulkhead so that the rest of the station isn't destroyed, but the computer doesn't respond, so Nora must open it and force start it under extreme pressure and limited time. Fortunately, she succeeds, but she chooses to wait before locking up because there are two more crew members coming down a hallway. They won't be able to reach them before the breach, therefore she had to close the doors to prevent the disaster from spreading, leaving those two guys behind. The computer they're using explodes, knocking Nora and Rodrigo out for a few seconds. When they wake up, the emergency recording informs them that the station is 70% damaged. Rodrigo believes it was an earthquake, but there are some strange noises coming from outside. Nora tries to contact for help but is unable, so she takes Rodrigo and goes in search of the escape pods. After checking their position and status in the CPU room, they must go down a debris-filled hallway to reach the pods. As they cautiously cross the rubble, they hear a voice screaming for help and locate Paul Abel behind a pile of boulders. He joins them after recovering his stuffed rabbit. The three of them crawl through a very tight area, and even come across the body of another crewmate before arriving at the pod bay, where Captain Lucien has remained while others escaped in the evacuation pods, all of which have already been launched. While Nora works on unjamming the entrance with a computer, Lucien sent Paul and Rodrigo to check on the submersibles. When the door is unlocked, Lucien takes Nora inside and checks her for injuries. Nora finds scientist Emily Haversham and engineer Liam Smith, who are in a relationship. As the other three men join them, Emily tells them that the energy accumulating in the station has nowhere to go and might produce a meltdown at any moment. Because they have no method of contacting the surface, Lucien advises they go to a separate facility, the Robux 641, which would require them to wear pressurized suits and trek 2 miles without knowing what could be waiting for them outside, but the crew is opposed to the idea. Liam plays a tape of the last message from the drill site, which sounds like the guys were attacked by the same mystery noise Nora had heard earlier. The temperature outside has also increased by 10 degrees, which is illogical because water does not do this. They accept the plan to travel to the Robux since they have no other option. The team begins to put on their suits. Emily is anxious since she has never dived before. Paul remembers to bring his stuffed rabbit, and Rodrigo double-checks the two remaining helmets before handing one to Nora. Liam chooses to take a pistol before leaving because of the noises he heard in the tape, and Paul does the same. When everyone is ready, they board the elevator, and Liam informs them that the outer hatch has been ripped to pieces, so they should all grab on tight since the pressure will be intense. Nora detects cracks on Rodrigo's helmet and attempts to warn Liam not to open the door, but it's too late, the water strikes them and Rodrigo's helmet implodes, killing him. They don't have time to be sad, they need to start moving. So they board a cargo lift. Nora feels terrible since she believes Rodrigo knew his helmet was broken and purposefully gave her the last decent one, but Lucien advises her to get used to it. They hear a distress signal from one of the pods as the lift lowers them. Lucien sent Paul and Liam to investigate the possibility of rescuing more survivors. Paul gives Emily his rabbit before departing. It's dark outside, and the platforms are unsteady, but the boys keep going as Nora directs. The unusual noises from previously can be heard here as well, and they discover that the pod has collapsed and is being covered by some strange algae-like creature. They also discover a dead, so Lucien tells them to return because there is no one to rescue, but Paul refuses. A strange, liquefied figure on the back of the body distracts him, and it suddenly moves and attacks him. Liam shoots the creature, and they carry it inside shortly afterwards. Emily studies it, observing its talons and the mouth it used to eat on the body, but there are no eyes to be seen. She's discussing the possibility of discovering a new species when the elevator abruptly loses electricity and stops moving. Outside, the previous noises can be heard, and Paul believes the thing they have is a baby, so he locks the door tightly. Nora is able to distance the elevator, but they are still not going. Just as the Kepler is about to burst, an adult creature approaches at the window. The elevator begins to fall out of control, and the crew moves to put their helmets before hitting the seafloor. They barely make it out in time. Once outdoors, they must move quickly since debris from the explosion is falling all around them. Liam is injured, but Lucien and Nora save him and assist him in reaching an intermediate station, where they find his oxygen scrubber has been broken. Unfortunately, the mover is forced to stop midway because the tunnel is flooded, so they continue on foot, only to find that more debris is obstructing their path. Nora volunteers to dive in to locate a new route out because she is the tiniest, and she succeeds. Lucien wires each crew member before sending them in, all except Paul, who can be heard stating he sees something behind him. Because he isn't coming in, the team begins pulling on the cables to bring him with them. They are able to pull him through, but as soon as he removes his helmet, before putting his helmet back on, his wire is pulled from the other side. Paul gives them his bunny, and the team tries everything they can to retain hold of him, but it's too late. A creature pulls him straight out of the suit and kills him. The group runs before the creature catches up with them and arrives in a communications room, where Lucien unsuccessfully attempts to request assistance. Liam notices the drill through the glass and questions how it could have been destroyed so easily when it weighs 6,000 tons. Emily responds that it is their fault for going too deep into the ocean below, which she is now correcting. Nora agrees with her opinion that no one should be down there. They can't remain in there any longer, says Lucien, since the window is starting to shatter, but they're afraid about Liam because his suit won't be able to make it. He advises them to leave him behind because he'll be useless, but the others resist and decide to assist him in walking. The four of them set out to explore the ocean floor, and it isn't long until a monster swims about them. They switch off the suit lights, but it's not much of a help since the thing reappears and takes Liam, dragging him to a cave. Lucien enters the cave and finds him alive since they can still see his foot near the opening, so he begins pulling him out. Lucien returns to the cave to get the gun, but the thing finds him and drags him farther into, taking Nora with him because she's tied up to him by the cables. Nora falls on a floating platform and Lucien hangs tangled at the edge of it. She plans to aid him, but the creature shows up and approaches closer to put its mouth on her helmet. Lucien leaps on the thing, causing it to drag them along with it as it dives further into the ocean. Because the pressure is about to kill them both, Lucien sacrifices himself and unhooks his suit from Nora's, allowing her to float away before he implodes. Nora faints for a few seconds, and when she awakens, she realizes that her suit is deteriorating. After being surprised by an octopus, she escapes and discovers a door that lets her to access the abandoned Shepherd station. She checks out the area after sobbing over her captain's death and changing into dry clothing. Trying to send Emily a message fails, but she does discover a map of the drilling location in Lucien's old locker. Determined to survive, she dons a new suit she found and takes a flare gun before returning to the ocean below to try to reach the Roebuck as planned. She's following the markers when she hears Emily's voice, so she rushes towards her, causing Emily to escape as well, believing Nora is one of the creatures. Nora leaps on top of her and comforts her, telling her how proud she is of her for surviving and keeping her boyfriend alive. They pull Liam over the floor as they resume walking, keeping their troubled minds occupied with chit-chat. Nora tells Emily about her fiancé, Liam's closest buddy who vanished on a solo diving mission. They eventually arrive to the blazing Roebuck station. As they enter, they notice a nest of those animals dangling from the ceiling, apparently sleeping or hibernating. The girls try to slip past after turning off their suit lights, but their plan fails when Emily's oxygen alarm goes off. One of the monsters awakens and snatches Nora, telling Emily to grab Liam and hurry to the door. When the thing begins to engulf Nora, she pulls out her flare gun and fires her from within, effectively freeing herself. The rest of the animals are waking up as well, so Nora prepares a second flare gun, only to witness the creatures being carried by something big and roaring. Nora fires her flare gun into the distance, only to realize that the monster approaching her is the legendary Cthulhu. After a brief moment of astonishment, she begins to run, but Cthulhu appears behind her and creates an explosion that knocks her out. Emily, who rescues her and takes her inside the station, saves her. Nora's oxygen is running low, but her helmet is stuck, so Emily gets a fire extinguisher and cracks the helmet, allowing Nora to breathe again. After assisting Liam in getting out of his suit, the three of them rush down several hallways until they reach the control room, where they can see Cthulhu and its creatures through the glass. Nora consults the station map on the computer before directing her crewmates to the pod bay. The station is gradually flooding, and the emergency system is locking several entrances, but they manage to make their way out after escaping some oncoming waves. There are three pods waiting for them, but only two of them are operational, and Nora fails to alert the others. They put Liam in the first pod and send him out with Paul's plush bunny. Then it's Emily's time, but she refuses to go in after discovering of Nora's lie. Because they're running out of time, Nora strikes Emily and puts her into the pod, telling her everything will be okay before sending her out. Nora has accepted her fate, but she becomes concerned when she sees the monsters are pursuing the pods. She devises a strategy to avoid feeling powerless in her final moments. Remembering Emily's statement that the stations had a lot of collected energy with nowhere to go, Nora uses the computer to start an overload of the Robux nuclear core, causing a large explosion that kills her, Cthulhu, and its monsters and lets the pods to leave safely. The film ends with numerous news pieces and reports stating that all information is classified and that no one is permitted to speak with the survivors. All surveillance film has been deleted, likely as a result of the damage, and Tian Industries refuses government assistance with the inquiry since they intend to rebuild and continue drilling. Subscribe and turn on the notifications. We daily upload videos like this.